Hello guys, welcome back to Orthodox Techie channel. In our previous video, we learned about Active Directory. We also learned about how to configure Active Directory through GUI. So, based on our previous video, you know what is Active Directory is. Active Directory is a directory service that holds all data in a computer and uses information in a single place. To explain in a better way, I will assume some one example. Okay, if you are a person and you got information from one of the user, and information is nothing but a name and a phone number. Before using this information, you need to verify the information you got is right or wrong. Where you can find the information is right or wrong? You know about telephone directory. Okay, the telephone directory contains all the information of the person, like person name, phone number, and their email ID, and the address information in a single book. And you know the person who holds the telephone directory. Okay, what you can do? You can give the information to that person and ask him to verify the information is right or wrong. The person who holds the telephone directory helps you to verify the information. So he will get the information from you and check the list from the telephone directory, and information is correct means he will acknowledge the result to you. So after getting the confirmation from the person who holds the telephone directory, you can able to use the information. Likewise, the person who holds the telephone directory is similar to domain controller in our concept. And the telephone directory itself is an active directory. And the person who requesting the information, requesting the verification is the domain computer, like you. You are requesting the information to the person. So you are a domain computer. You got the information from the user. And in order to check the information, you are requesting the active directory. You are requesting the domain controller to check the active directory, and domain controller on the other hand will check the active directory and acknowledge you with the information. So this is a general concept of active directory. Okay, let me go on to the configuration part. So for configuration part, we need to create a lab so that we can able to install active directory as a service in a server OS, and you can able to configure the domain controller. So for configuration, we need some tools for this lab. So for this lab, I'm using a VMware workstation. VMware workstation is nothing but a virtualization tool where you can able to create multiple VMs with a OS you wish. So for this lab, I am using VM workstation as a virtualization tool. If you want to use another virtualization, means you can able to use Hyper-V is another virtualization which will be shipped, which you can have it as a free tool for a Windows server. So it's a tool inbuilt within the Windows 10 itself. If you have a Windows 10 software, you can enable Hyper-V and use it as a virtualization tool. Where you can another virtualization tool is a VirtualBox, which is Oracle product. It's also a free tool. So let me get into the configuration part. Before that, we need OS file to create a new VM. Where you can find the OS file for free? Microsoft itself is providing an evaluation copy for the OS file to create a lab. Go to Microsoft or search in Google as an evaluation product for Windows Server. You will have this link as a link from a Microsoft site where you can able to download the Windows Server OS as a ISO file. And also you can go to search for VirtualBox to download the virtualization software. It is a free software. And go to VMware player. VMware Workstation is a payable product, and VMware Player is a free product. So I am using VMware Workstation here. I already downloaded the ISO file. So in order to create a VM, go to file and select new virtual machine, give next and select or browse to the ISO file you need to create and give next, give the name of the VM you need to create and the location of the VM file to save, give next and select the virtual hard disk size. You can able to select virtual hard disk as a single partition or you can able to select virtual hard disk as a multiple partition. So I am giving as a single partition here and you will have the description of the VM and you can also customize the VM if you want, if you need to increase the memory size or if you need to increase the processor count, you can able to do. So I am already having a server VM. So I am just powering on the server VM here. So I am using Windows Server 2016. You can use any OS itself before Windows 16 also up to 2003 because 2003 is the tool where they introduce Active Directory as a service. So before using 2016, if you are using 2012, the viewpoint will be same similar, but 2008 the viewpoint will be something different. It will differ with the Windows Server 2016 versions. So it's powering on the VM. You need another VM also for a client machine so that the client machine able to join to the domain controller. Okay, I'm also in another OS machine as a server OS as a client also you can able to create. So okay, it's boot up. I'm logging into the machine. So in this video, we are not going to use any GUI here. We are going to configure entire AD within PowerShell. PowerShell is a command line tool, very powerful tool. It's a next version of command line. So as an administrator, you should get familiar with the PowerShell. Okay. So once boot up, the server manager will pop up. Okay, go to server manager. So, okay, server manager is a GUI version of server where it is a single administrative console where you can able to manage multiple roles, where you can able to manage multiple server as well, where you can able to create roles and features, we can install roles and features in a multiple machines as well. So server manager is loading. Okay, before creating this machine into a Active Directory, we need to have a static IP for this server so that we can able to create an Active Directory. I am going to check whether the static IP has been configured here or not. Okay, static IP is configured here. Since we are going to install DNS as well, we need to configure the DNS IP also here. So I'm going to do that in a PowerShell. Okay, this is the PowerShell command line where you can able to provide commandlets to install something or do a task. First of all, I need to get IP address. Okay, the machine name is server 1, and IP assigned as 20.10, which is a static IP, and no DNS IP has been configured, so it's getting a default DNS IP like loopback address. So I'm going to configure DNS IP for this. I'm going to say this IP as a DNS, so because this server is going to function as a DNS as well. So set DNS client server address and interface aliases. So before you configuring interface alias, you need to know what is the interface alias for the particular network adapter, because in server you may have a multiple network adapters. So for that we need to get net adapter command. So you will find two network adapter here. So I'm going to use the host only network adapter. Here I'm just copying that. So you need to give command as set DNS client server address interface alias. You can also give interface index as also. If you want to give interface index, I will give interface index is like 8 for host only network adapter. I'm giving 8 and server address as, I'm going to give the same address, the local machine IP, and that's it. The DNS IP has been assigned. You can cross verify that also, like going once again giving IP, seeing IP config all configured. Okay, see here the DNS IP has been assigned. So now going to install Windows feature, Windows role for ADDS. So before installing Windows roles, you need to check what are the roles has been installed or what are the roles you can install in this. So for that you can give get Windows feature command. So once you get enter, it will collect all the features which are shipped with the server OS, and if the square bracket has been crossed with the X, means that service has been installed in this local server. So you need to install, we need to install Active Directory domain services for this. So I'm just copying this name of this Active Directory domain service and giving install Windows feature as command and name as subcommand and giving the name of the role to install. So I'm giving I'm including all the sub features that are included in the AD domain services, and also including management tools also to manage this role through PowerShell command or through GUI. There is no need to install, no need to give a restart command for installing this Windows feature. So I'm giving this enter. So it's getting information and starting installation into the local machine. So as an administrator, please get familiar with the using PowerShell command lines, because so when you are installing server core, there will be no GUI to configure anything. You can only able to use a only command prompt tool or a PowerShell tool. So in a big office environment, you can able to find so much of server core environments are there. Environments will be there for reducing resource purpose. So get familiar to using command line tools. to do your task. It's pretty easy before after you getting familiar. Okay. See, we got the result as a true. I'm getting success as a result. So it installed Active Directory Domain Service in a local machine. So now we need to promote this local server with the installed Active Directory role to domain controller. To do that, we need to create, we need to do install as it is a first domain server we are going to create. So we are creating as a forest. So ADDS forest. So there is no need to memorize every command you using here. Just give help if you are any confusion with using command. Just give help install ADDS forest. Just give help as a command to get help. You will get the name of the command and the syntax to use within the command. I'm just for easy purpose, I'm just copying this command to explain you and give it as a notepad, pasting in a notepad. Okay, I'm just reducing this window so you can see the command I'm going to use. Okay. So I'm just to copy the syntax of the command we are going to install. Okay. I'm going to explain one by one command. So we need to put the initial command, command name as well. So I'm going to add the initial command and domain name. We need to provide domain name to create a domain, name of the domain. Okay, I'm giving us demo.local, and after that we skip prechecks, and it's in a square bracket, which means you can use at least an optional. There is no necessary to use this command, so it's an optional command. If you need, means you can use, otherwise you can omit as well. And safe administrator password we can give later wise, or else if you enter the command it will automatically ask the password to give administrator password. So I'm not going to create a delegation DNS delegation because we are installing the DNS within the local server, so we are going to omit that command as well. And you are going to give a database path. So I'm giving database path. So when you promoted this local server as a domain server, that entire account information, that entire account login information will be moved to the particular folder that is called as NTDS folder. So we are going to give folder name as NTDS. So after that, DNS delegation credential, since we are not using DNS here, DNS delegation here, we are not going to give this command. And after that, no DNS on network, no, we are going to use DNS being installed in this machine. So we are going to omit that command. So we are going to use domain mode for the command. So I'm giving this apostrophe symbol, we are going to the next line. So our domain mode, you can have a multiple options of Windows OS versions. We are going to use win threshold. So when you are using Win Threshold, it will use upstream end of a server up to the local server's version. So as we are using Windows Server 2016, it will take it as a 2016. And we are going to use this domain whereas command also. So we are going to give name as demo. So, and forest mode also, we are going to give win threshold. So, then install DNS. We are going to install DNS in this local machine as well. So, log path will be a same as NTDS database path. So, we are giving Windows NTDS as a folder name and apostrophe for next line, and no reboot for completion. As for domain controller, it is mandatory to reboot, so we are going to skip that command. We are going to skip this command as well. And for sysfault path, for sysfault path, we need to give a separate sysfault folder because the entire policies will be stored in a sysfault folder. We don't want to mesh with the sysfault folder, so giving us Windows sysfault folder. So, this is the command to promote the local AD machine as a domain controller. That's it. So, when you are giving enter, it will ask for password, administrator password we need to provide. I am giving simple password for now. So it will ask for confirmation, give A for confirmation. Okay, after it's now checking any prerequisite verifications. So after validating this prerequisite, it will automatically restart and promote this server to a domain controller. Meanwhile, we are going to create a domain machine, this server as a domain client. So I'm just power on this server. So we are going to use this server OS as a domain client to join the domain controller. Okay, all tests has been completed. Now it is restarting the machine. So it's automatically restarting the machine. So in meanwhile, the client machine, we are going to configure client machine. So client machine is booted up. So I'm getting into client machine. The machine which you are going to use it as a domain client. So I'm logging to the mission. So as usual, before joining to any domain controller, we need to be in the same network, and we need to have a DNS IP of that machine, so that only you can able to communicate with the domain controller to get into the machine is booted up. So before joining this machine to the domain controller, we need to check what's the IP of the DNS. So for that, I'm going to PowerShell as well. I'm checking the DNS IP of this client machine. So when you are in the same DNS network only, you can able to join the domain controller. Okay, it's restarting. Domain controller is restarting. Okay, now I'm going to check the DNS IP of the client machine now. It's like same command ipconfig space / all. So it will give the entire IP name. The machine name has been seen as server 2. And IP has been assigned as 20.20. Okay, so DNS IP, we didn't find any DNS IP here, it's just a loopback IP. So we need to set the DNS IP, which is domain controller's IP. So I'm giving command set DNS client server address. So before that, the domain client also can have a multiple network adapters, so we need to check what network adapters are there. So get net adapter, okay, here are the network adapters which are present in domain client machine. So we are going to use the host only network adapter. So I'm giving set DNS client server address interface alias. I'm giving name for now and server address 192.168.20.10, which is a domain controller IP. So I'm giving, okay, that's it. The DNS IP has been assigned to domain client. Now if you want to verify, you can give the same command as ipconfig / all, and see, the DNS IP has been assigned. So now you can able to join this machine to the domain controller. The domain controller is getting started, getting ready. So once it is ready, we can able to join this machine to domain controller. For joining the domain controller, we can use a simple command in a PowerShell itself, like add computer is a command. Add computer is a command. And domain, we need to provide the domain name to which domain controller we are going to add. The domain controller or domain name is demo.local, which we have created before, and we need to provide domain credential which have the authorized to join the client machines to domain controller. I'm giving demo administrator as a domain credential and restart as a command to restart this local machine to join as a domain client after giving this command. So we are going to check whether the servo machine is up and right. Okay, PowerShell is a very big tool introduced from Microsoft. Better try to understand each and every command and what are the functions that command do, and try to use the help command where you can use to get help from the command. You can also use man command if you are a Linux administrator. Man command is like getting manual of that command. You can also use man command for that. So it's just a alias name for getting help command. Man command as a alias name for get help command. It's getting quite late. Okay, the server has been, domain controller server has been booted now. So just I'm going to log into this domain controller machine. So as soon as the machine has been logged in, the servo manager console will be popped up. As usual, just we are going to close and open PowerShell. Since now we are not added any computer or any user ID here, if you want to get the information about the computer added here, get AD computer, just give get AD computer list, and it will show the list of computers added with this domain. So it's asking filter command as well. So if you give filter and asterisk as a command to get all the list. Okay, so we have only one machine, server one, which is a local domain controller itself. So this is the domain controller which is come under one domain controller OU. So other than this, no domain machine has been added under this domain controller. So we are now adding this domain, we are now adding this client machine to the domain controller by giving this command as add computer domain name and give that domain name and domain credential to authorize this joining and give restart command. So I'm giving this command, it will ask the credential. Give the credential of that administrator user ID, and that's it. It restarting, and the client machine will be added to that domain controller. So, once the machine has been booted, this local machine will be added as a domain client to the domain controller. So, if you reused this domain get AD computer filter command, you will get another list which is a server 2. Just now we added the server 2. So that server 2 will come under domain computers list. So this machine is now under a domain. So if you want to log into domain with a domain user, you can able to, which are created in this domain controller. You can able to log in with that user ID in the domain machine. Hope you all understand this. Let me see after in the next channel we can see how to create a user and how to configure certain policies to domain clients in a next video. Bye.